It's been 10 days since our first planting, so we have to plant again. And I know I should be excited for it, and I am. But I can't stop thinking about this bean plant from yesterday and that long taproot. I imagine that by the end of this, we're going to have beans and peas running roots all the way across the bed. That's going to be really great for nitrogen fixing inside this soil. Along with all that worm action, should make it a really great living environment for all the rest of these plants. Worry about one thing, though. I think I'm probably underwatering. I'm really worried about overwatering. So yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm underwatering. Once I do another planting, I'm going to consider how and when, today or tomorrow, I should really water the whole thing again. The only other question there is, what kind of effect is that going to have on the worms? We know that in a natural environment, worms in the rain just start coming up to the surface. Is that going to start happening here? I really have no idea. We're just going to have to wait and see. In the meantime, it's planting time. Let's start with the green beans. I'm going to plant two, one on each of these quadrants. That way, hopefully, they will still match up with the other side. We'll plant our one yellow bean right here. Next up is kale. We're going to put the new kale right here. And I'm only planting three seeds this time, because we had a pretty great germination rate. I'm going to cover those up. Then I have another new method. I'm laying this down because I know I'm going to go and have watering later, and I don't want to disturb this soil. So I'm hoping this will act as some kind of a helpful barrier. I can water straight through the top. Next up is the romaine, and the same thing applies. I'm only going to put three seeds into each spot, and I'm going to match the three spots. Next row is the black-seeded Simpson. Three seeds to a spot. And the last in the row, the buttercrunch. We're still waiting on these peppers, but there's nothing else to really plant in this row except the spinach. The radishes will be moved to here, so all we need are three new rows of spinach. I'm only planting two spinach seeds in each spot. I like the way this green onion's coming in. I'm actually just going to plant a whole row of it right in front of it. Next is the three arugula. Now the radishes. And finally,
5 carrots in the last row.
Thanks for sticking around for the planting. As I run my fingers through this soil, I can feel it's really dry on the top. It's not holding anything in, which makes me think there's nothing on the bottom that's still coming up. I'm definitely going to have to water this tomorrow, and I'm going to have to be smart and careful about it because I still have plants that could be damaged from too heavy of a watering. See you tomorrow.